Good morning, my friends and colleagues. First of all, on behalf of Indian Dental Association, IDA, head office, I would like to thank each one of you for agreeing to participate in this great initiative, which is the National Oral Cancer Registry. We are rolling this out in this current year, 2018, and it's glad for me to know that almost more than 50 plus institutions have enrolled for this program, and I'm sure with the word of mouth, it will spread to other institutions as well. So what is National Oral Cancer Registry? It's an initiative of Indian Dental Association. Basically, it's a mechanism to collect and classify information across the country on oral cancers, basically potential malignant lesions and conditions, so that we have a centralized cancer incidence reporting system. What happens till date is we do our work in silos. We have data, but it's geographic specific, college specific, which as a part of publication, but it doesn't generalize to the entire population or entire country. And hence there are challenges. We have a challenge of not having enough data across the country, and if we, all the colleges, come across a multicentric level, it can be create a good report for us to understand the real picture of oral cancer and how to shape policies in future. It's important because 4 in 10 in all cancers are oral cancer. India, being in a state of diverse use of tobacco as well as smokeless, as well as betel nut use, it creates a high risk to the population, especially those who are at a low socioeconomic class, those who are at remote rural areas where awareness about the product is there, but still the health seeking behavior is very less. Hence, it becomes vital for us to have this centralized reporting mechanism, and it can push the policymakers of what can be done in future in the best way. NOCR, which is National Oral Cancer Registry, will enable us to provide a central pooling of data, both precancers and cancers, oral cancers. Hence, we can identify what are the strategies to prevent it. We can help in building better practices across the country. It will help the researchers, hospitals and institutions to analyze the demographic factors, to analyze the geographic factors, and to understand what are the early detection strategies and treatment for oral cancer patients. Dental profession can use this registry in a defined area to make public health decisions, to maximize the effectiveness of health funds, as well as placement of effective screening programs. Screening programs are there, but the major challenge is that we don't have an established referral network. We all do as a part of a regular screening program, as a part of a public health department. We do our outreach programs, but what happens once the patient is screened? What's happened? Who follows it up? Whether they have undertaken the treatment, whether there is a good follow-up, or there is a loss to follow-up. So this helps us to track the patient in his journey from entire cancer. We have seen that the burden is increasing in the country. There is a lot of patients reporting at stage 3 and stage 4, and they have to go to a tertiary care center like Tata Memorial Hospitals or any of the government institution to take the care. The cost of the treatment is high. There is no enough insurance coverage for the same, and hence we want to downstage the oral cancer, catch them early, so it's detected at precancerous lesions level and make the treatment or screening programs more effective. The data would also help to direct some innovative educational campaigns which can be customized to the local level. We can have a good use of technology, so maybe in future a mobile based technology can be used where the identified lesions can be sent in a cloud based system, and a specialist sitting at the tertiary level or at the Tata Cancer Hospital can see the lesions and give in real time what is the way forward. It can identify regions or states with high rates of oral cancers, and hence this becomes very crucial when we have a dialogue with the government or with the tertiary care institutes, both at the private level and at the non-government level, to come together and join hands so that at the end of the day the community or the patient gets benefit. This is a year-on-year process. So we'll start as a year, first year, from 2018 Jan till December, and by end of the 1 year we'll get actually what is the cancer burden in the country. So it becomes a more a decentralized pooling of the patients and getting it in a more centralized structured manner. This will eliminate the current scenario that is a lag of bigger picture, which is what due to the treatment going on in bits and pieces across the country. on becoming NOCR, the college will also get benefit. How you will be benefit? The main question is how the institution get benefits. It helps them to create a good database of the patient records, which already few of the institutions have, but we have to have a more robust system so that more research insights can be, you know, taken further. And also from the IDA, the institution which provides and maintains the maximum data can be felicitated in the Indian Annual Conference 2019 or in any other conferences which IDA hosts. So there are a lot of opportunities, there are a lot of learnings from the academic point of view, from the institution point of view, from the learning from point of view, and as well as for doing further research in an area. So we can think of going from a more diagnosis and early detection to a molecular level where we can understand the molecular pattern of people who are using tobacco or arecanut and different forms of smoking, to understand how we can catch them here. So maybe a simple test of using a kit where a saliva can be used as a biomarker, and it can help us to detect whether the lesions can go into a malignancy or not. How can we help? It's mainly the dental colleges and hospitals which treat mass patients at affordable prices. And usually the tobacco users are there, but they don't come for a habit, but they usually come for their heart issues problems, mainly the dental caries or replacement of the missing teeth. They must be made aware of the hazards of tobacco use, and also you can build in the tobacco cessation program. So it falls perfectly in place. You have a data monitoring mechanism. You can have your PG students to undertake one of the research topic and try to answer a few of the questions. It can motivate them to maintain the registry and maintain a good solid data. Also from the inspection point of view from Dental Council, you can easily show that this is a very good data monitoring mechanism we have in place, and that helps in the part of the institution. The NOCR is usually guided by a committee which is spread across the India from north, south, east, west, which is headed by a chairman, Dr. B.V. Ramana Reddy. From the chief advisor for the project is Dr. Ranganathan K. We have a vice chairman from east zone, Dr. Rachna Rath. From the west zone, we have Dr. Yashwant Ingle. From the south, we have Smita Tamaya. And from the north zone, we are awaiting confirmation from few of the experts. Myself, Dr. Kunal Oswal, as a public health consultant to the project. Dr. Prerna Gaitonde, who is the main lead in charge for the NOCR. And office bearers from IDA, Dr. Ashok Doble, Honorable General Secretary, and our president, Dr. Vishwas Puranik. Coming to the website, the software, it's already up and live. You can access the software. The login is www.nocr.org.in. It has basically all the information of oral cancer and the cancer registry. You can click on the web page and understand what the vision is. We have made particular tools basically to understand about the awareness factors, the risk factors and treatment options. As a professional, you can use it to consult and guide your patients who are battling with oral cancers. You can also have a better understanding of the registry and how it works in the professional lab group. So it is customized in such a way that at each level, whether it's a public, as a student, as a professional, you can use it for your own research work, and you can have it up and running in your own clinic or in an institution. You can find out about the current scenarios and statistics related to oral cancer. So we are trying to upgrade it. We are trying to build on whatever the evidence is, as well as whatever new innovative research which is there up and on the website. This being the oral cancer, and we as a guardian of oral health, it's a good opportunity for us in a country where we have 300 plus colleges and various institutions and hospitals to come up with a very specific oral cancer registry. There are government initiatives, what the government is planning at the policy level.